Mercury does not always receive a lot of attention. The innermost planet to the Sun, measuring just 3,032 miles wide at its equator, is smaller than both Jupiter's moon, Ganymede, and Saturn's moon, Titan. It has been overshadowed by worlds like Mars that may have once harbored life, and planets that are solar systems unto themselves like Jupiter and Saturn. But it has many unique characteristics that are very interesting. Even building a self-sustained research station is not out of question. Mercury is particularly interesting to scientists who study exoplanets, planets that orbit other stars. Thousands of known exoplanets orbit extremely close to their stars. By studying Mercury right here in our backyard, we can better understand what these close orbiting worlds might be like. The small and cratered planet does not have any moons and zips around the Sun faster than any other planet in the solar system, speeding along at about 29 miles per second and completing each orbit around the Sun in just 88 Earth days. Hence, why the Romans named it after their swift-footed messenger god. From the surface of Mercury, the Sun would appear more than three times as large as it does when viewed from Earth, and the sunlight would be as much as seven times brighter. If you could watch the skies from the surface of Mercury, you would sometimes catch the rear sight of the Sun in retrograde, as Mercury makes its closest approach to our smoldering star. Its orbital speed exceeds its rate of rotation on its axis. That means someone standing on Mercury would see the Sun start to rise, then briefly set, then rise again all within the same day. Mercury is a world of extremes. Its surface appears old, cratered, and undisturbed by recent geologic activity. Mercury's surface resembles that of Earth's moon, scarred by many impact craters resulting from collision with meteorites and comets. Very large impact basins, including Caloris, 960 miles or 1,550 kilometers in diameter, and Rachmaninoff, 190 miles or 306 kilometers in diameter, were created by asteroid impact on the planet's surface early in the solar system's history. While there are large area of smooth terrain, there are also cliffs some hundreds of miles long and soaring up to a mile high. They rose as planet's interior cooled and contracted over the billion of years since Mercury formed. Yet it has a magnetic field which is normally caused by a molten core that should in turn cause surface changes. Despite its proximity to our star, Mercury is not the hottest planet in the solar system. Temperatures on Mercury are extreme. During the day, temperatures on the surface can reach 800 degrees Fahrenheit, 430 degrees Celsius. Because the planet has no atmosphere to retain that heat, night temperatures on the surface can drop to minus 290 degrees Fahrenheit, minus 180 degrees Celsius. By contrast, the surface of hazy Venus sits at a sweltering 880 degrees Fahrenheit year-round, making it the hottest planet in our solar system. Lack of an atmosphere also means Mercury's surface is pockmarked by numerous impact craters. Since incoming material do not encounter any friction that would cause them to burn up. Instead of an atmosphere, Mercury possesses a thin exosphere made up of atoms blasted off the surface by the solar wind and striking meteorites. Mercury's exosphere is composed mostly of oxygen, sodium, hydrogen, helium, and potassium. Mercury may have water ice at its north and south poles inside deep craters, but only in regions in permanent shadows. In those shadows, it could be cold enough to preserve water ice despite the high temperatures on sunlit parts of the planet. These shadows will be the perfect place to build research stations where scientists and astronauts can safely study Mercury on the surface. This luxury is not available on most other planets of the solar system. Only three spacecraft have ever visited Mercury. In the 1970s, NASA's Mariner 10 made three flybys of the planet, seeing the same side each time, revealing its crater-ridden surface and magnetic field. No spacecraft visited again until NASA's Messenger became the first spacecraft to orbit Mercury in 2011. Messenger gave us a more complete picture of the planet than ever before. The spacecraft revealed Mercury to have an unusual large core and an offset magnetic field. Messenger also found the planet to be surprisingly rich in volatiles, elements that evaporate at room temperature, including finding ample evidence of water ice on Mercury's poles. This helped scientists rule out many of its previously suggested formation models, while also advancing our knowledge of how the solar system formed and evolved. Scientists are not sure why Mercury's core makes up 85% of the planet's volume, much more than Earth's, which makes up just 15%. The answer may help us understand the possibilities for different types of planets and how our solar system evolved. Why does Mercury have such a large core, and how does it generate the planet's magnetic field? These are the questions that BepiColombo, a joint Japanese-European Mercury mission that launched in 2018, will attempt to answer. BepiColombo will arrive in Mercury's orbit in 2025. The mission will study water ice at Mercury's poles. Hope you enjoyed this documentary. Hit the bell icon, like, subscribe, and share. See you soon. Bye-bye.